Especially it being thrown in 13th. The fact I didn't put it in the wall was great. Well, after leaving Thunder Hill, brought the car back and completely tore it apart. Front of the car was no longer attached to the back of the car. Yeah, then we basically stripped it down and took it to Chilton Auto Body, where they did a fantastic job of repainting it into this lovely Lotus Isotope green.
And then from there, we went on to the first race weekend. Started by taking the car as it was presented to us, the way we bought it. We expected it to be a winning car because that's what we were told. It was a last race that it had was at Sonoma, and Mike had won the championship in the race that day. It turned out to be a bit more difficult than that.
It was a brand new circuit for us. The car obviously was still very, very new to us. And the series is a lot more competitive than what I was running last year. I was really fighting the car come the Friday and really struggling. As the weekend went on, we put the new tyres on and they made a world of difference. We went about, I think, 4 seconds quicker once we put the new rubber on. And we went from, yeah, being about 5.5 seconds of the pace to just over a second of the pace. So that was nice. I was a bit worried before that. We were going to be really uncompetitive, but once that was on, that was great, and I felt that was the point when we really started to learn the car and actually learn how to start setting it up. Almost the first day was more for learning the circuit and not crashing. So warm up on the Saturday, we still did the old tyres, and that was when we were really dog slow. Then qualifying, put the new rubber on, and we quickly had to change the setup to get the car drivable. That session was pretty tough because the car was super loose and had a couple of big moments at high speed. I think turn 10 had half a turn opposite lock coming out of that, and basically aiming us at a wall to save a massive slide. So that was, you know, that wasn't the best. But we set a reasonable lap time actually, considering how badly behaved the car was. I thought I did pretty well actually in that session. And then come the race, we were still, you know, in fifth place for qualifying. I didn't really know what to expect, and you know, the guys are quick, and I just was going to try as hard as I can. I was super keen. Found, at least for the setup of the car, is that it can be all right for a lap or two on the tyres, and then we really start to punish the rear tyres and it becomes tricky to drive. And that's what kind of happened. I slid wide on two, and one of the competitors got by me, and then I was holding on for fourth place then for a fair few laps, and then the tyres really started to give up towards the end of the race, and I had a little spin in 11th. The spin was fine, but I knew the guy behind me was very, very close. And I, as you know, you spun around and then you looked at him in the eye, had a little moment. And I'm like, oh, he's gonna hit me, he's gonna knock my front wing off. And I was like, oh, and waiting for the hit. And it didn't happen, and I don't know how he did it, but he managed to squeeze by me on the inside. So that was like, rubbish. Collected myself together, got the thing fired back up and spun around. And then at the end of that, I was really struggling. Like physically, I was finding it really tough. I hadn't been relaxing in the car towards the start of the race, so towards the end, I was just super tense and all my muscles were giving up. And it was difficult. And then Sunday came around and we really made some progress with the setup. It was a lot easier to drive. And we saw that relatively the times. So we made up a few tenths of it. Again, we started in fifth. Got a reasonable start, but not quite in the right position to make up places. And really, like my goal for that race was just to kind of settle into it, and then try and come on strong at the end of the race. And we managed to do that. Kept up with third and fourth for a long while, and then towards the end of the race, third started to break away, but I was able to pressure fourth, and through traffic, I managed to take it from fifth into fourth place, which we held in the race, really. Come back, new circuit, which is super technical, super physical, and difficult to set the car for. I think it's a pretty good job. I'm pretty satisfied, you know, as hard as it was during the weekend, when you look back on it, no, we did a good job. I think it was just so many steps into the unknown. We had no baselines or knowledge to go on. Because it's a new circuit, new tyres, new car, just didn't know where I stood. And you know, the setup on it was, we expected it to be good, and it turned out it didn't suit me, and it wasn't working right. So to basically come to a realisation that, you know, we really started from zero, and then, you know, having the confidence and the ability just to make the right changes to make the car better. It took a little while, but yeah, every change we did was positive, and each session, although we were messing around at the start of the weekend, you know, with old tyres, each change we did, we made the car better.
It was an eye-opener to see how competitive teams can be and how much knowledge you have to apply to the car. But I think for us qualifying within a reasonable time and being competitive with a car that was not optimal by any means, I think we have a steep learning curve, but we'll get there.